Soft robotics has become quite popular. And if we look at a lot of soft robots, they typically have maybe two or three actuators. But if we look at real biological systems like an octopus, they maybe have thousands of actuators in them. So the question we wanted to solve is, how do we bridge this gap from, you know, what we have now, which is two or three actuators, towards thousands of actuators that can mimic biological systems?
It's really hard to find a, you know, theoretical model to describe that kind of actuator arrays. So we try to use machine learning to figure out the internal couplings between the pixels. By using the machine learning model, we can achieve forward control and inverse control very, very fast.
There's kind of two innovations in this work. One is the machine learning aspect of how to control it. And the other part was, how do we actually get the voltage and the current to the actuating pixels themselves? Normally, if you have a huge number of pixels, you need a huge number of wires going into those. But by using matrix addressing, we were able to use only 12 wires going into the device to control 36 pixels. Normally, you would need to have something like 72 wires. So that kind of simplifies the actual physical system itself.
During my experiments, I started with some simple shapes, just like the wave shapes. And after that, we tried to make some more arbitrary shapes, like we achieved the flower shape, and also we achieved the P and the U, the letter P and the letter U.
There are a huge number of practical applications that we can eventually get to. Things like telepresence and haptics. That's so new that we don't even really know what the limits are or how far we can go with it.